In today's video, I will be showing you guys my top 10 most expensive Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Put your guesses in the comments. What could they be? What's up guys, Ruxin34 back with another video, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys, as you guys saw, my top 10 most expensive Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Before we do that, the giveaway for this video, I'll be giving away these three cards. We have Exodia the Legendary Defender, Winged Dragon of Ra, and Cypher the Shagai Dragon, all from Mega 10 2019. Really cool promos. All you have to do is like the video, be subscribed, and let me know your most expensive Yu-Gi-Oh card, or one of the most expensive if you don't want to say. Let's go ahead and get into it. There are 10 cards here, obviously, at the top 10. All graded cards, because that just makes them so much more valuable. It's hard for a raw card to be worth more than, you know, most graded cards. So let's go ahead and start. Number 10. When you have a graded card, there's not an exact value every time, because there might be a sale higher, might be a sale lower. You pretty much have to go off of sales. Sometimes there's no sales for months, so you kind of just have to guess or figure out what it might be worth. So these values are not 100% concrete. They're just kind of what I think they're worth, or what I heard from other people, or a sale that happened recently, something like that. So let's start off with number 10. We have Monster Reborn. This is the one I pulled out of the Legend of Blue Eyes box, first edition. The only 10 I got from the box, but still a really cool card. So this card is worth, I would say, around $2,000. It is a glossy print. It's not a wavy print. I think a wavy print went for like $3,000. I could be wrong. It's somewhere around $2,000. The reason this card is so expensive is, number one, it is graded in a perfect gem mint 10. So that is important. Then it is an ultra rare from Legend of Blue Eyes, the first ever Yu-Gi-Oh set. So it's pretty expensive. At the time when I pulled it, I think it was worth around $850 in a 10. So it has gone up since January, March, I think. Yeah. So this guy, I would say, is my number 10 most valuable card, Monster Reborn from Legend Blue Eyes. My number 9 most valuable card, my 9th most valuable card, I would say, is Beast Skull Dragon from Metal Raiders. This guy is worth, I would say, similar to the Monster Reborn, maybe a little bit more. I put it ahead of the Monster Reborn because it's a more iconic card, but I think the values are around the same. So I'll give this guy number 9 just because it's Beast Skull compared to, just, you know, Monster Reborn's cool, but this is a huge monster from Metal Raiders. One of the best pulls from Metal Raiders, it's this, Summon Skull, or like Gate Guardian of the top cards. So this guy, my number 9 most valuable card. My 8th most valuable card, I wasn't really sure what to value this guy at, because I have gotten, I once put it up on eBay like a while ago, like a few months ago, and I got a $2,000 offer like right away. Then I took it down, I put it up again later. It was up at like $5,000 or something, like, because I didn't really want to sell it, but there was something I wanted to buy, so if it was going to sell for a lot, then I would sell it. Someone else offered me $2,000, so I got two $2,000 offers. So I would say it's safely $2,000, because that was a while ago. I don't know if the value has gone up or down. You don't see these sell very much. So I have it at least $2,000, probably a little bit more. So that's why I have it ahead of the other two cards that have at $2,000. This is an ultimate rare version, by the way. There is a huge difference between super and ultimate. There is a super rare version of this as well. That card's probably worth like $100 in a 10 compared to this one, which is worth a lot more. The ultimate rares are much more valuable. So we have Cyber Dragon Ultimate Rare. I think I bought this for $750 or $725, I can't remember. Something like that last year. So I think it has gone up quite a bit, being the ultimate rare and one of the iconic GX cards, Cyber Dragons, you know. Cyber End Dragon is probably more iconic, but this one is still really strong. So I would say it's my 8th most valuable card. My 7th most valuable card is Blue Eyes Toon Dragon. This is a secret rare from Magic Ruler. For a long time, this card was worth $300 or less in a PSA 10. It was not worth much because there were a bunch of these. There were so many Magic Ruler boxes from, like, I think 2017 to like 2018. They were just everywhere. Blue Eyes Toon Dragons were everywhere. Like, they were pretty easy to get. But a recent auction went for $2,200. So even this guy, which originally was not super hyped up, has gotten actually pretty expensive. $2,200 Blue Eyes Toon Dragon Secret Rare. It is Gem Mint 10. If it got a 9, it'd probably be worth much less. I think the Near Mint version is now worth what the 10 used to be. It's like $300. So I actually pulled this one in a Magic Ruler opening. I opened a booster box. You guys can check out that video up there if you guys want to see it. I'd say he's my 7th most valuable card. My 6th most valuable card is the one and only Red Eyes Black Dragon. This one was actually pretty difficult to figure out a value on. I'm not totally sure what it should be. It is in a Beckett 9 case, but it also graded that PSA 9. You guys have seen that on my channel. If you haven't, You can check it out up there. But it's been a PSA 9 and a BGS 9, so I feel comfortable pricing it at a PSA 9 price. However, the PSA 9s aren't really coming up too much. You're seeing them around $2,000, $2,500. But this glossy red eyes, the one we pulled from the video, was absolutely insane. Front's really nice. The reason it got this 9 is it had like print lines you can't see on the back. So yeah, I would say this guy's my 6th most valuable card. My 5th most valuable card is this Black Rose Ghost Rare. You guys saw this return recently. It got a 9, unfortunately. I think it honestly should be a 10. I'm probably going to crack it and send it back in. So for now, it's a 9. And at a 9, I value it around $2,500, maybe a little bit more. 10s are worth so much because you can't even find them. So it's hard to even value a 10. It's hard to value anything. But I would say this guy's worth around $2,500 and a 9. Such a super... just a super tough card to get. I would say it's my 5th most valuable card, even with a PSA 9, which shows you how valuable this card is if we can get a Gem Mint 10. My 4th most valuable card, this one is a little bit weird. As I said, almost all of these are really hard to find like a real price and kind of price it out. Because I get a lot of questions, and they're like, hey, what do you price this at? I can price it, you know, but there's no real price. It's just kind of, what do you think it's worth? What has a sale been? But there's just not many sales for this. I think there was an Instagram sale for $3,500 for this one, but that was a while ago, so I'm not totally sure. I haven't seen much since then, so I'd value it around like $3,000, maybe $3,500. I'm not totally sure. The reason this guy is so expensive is Hobby GX is the most ridiculous thing ever. You have to open so many booster boxes to get an Ultra Ultimate, and what do I mean by Ultra Ultimate? In GX, if you have English boxes, not European, European's different. You have retail, which you can only pull the rares. Then you have Hobby, which you can pull Supers and Ultras as Ultimate Rares. But in Retail, you can only pull the Rares as Ultimate Rares. So this guy can only be pulled in the Hobby Box. So you got to pay up for the Hobby Box. Then you have to pull the Ultra Ultimate, which I've opened a lot of Hobby Boxes. It's like 20 boxes or something. And I've pulled like 2 or 3 Ultra Ultimates. It's super hard to pull them. So it's extremely hard to pull. Then you have to get the 10, which you guys saw. I pulled this and then it got a 9. For a year, it was a 9. So I regraded to 10. So you can't even get a 10 guaranteed. That's why this is so crazy expensive. It's also a cover card from GX, so the CyberDark Impact cover card is CyberDark Dragon. That makes this card extremely, extremely valuable. And if you're collecting the cover cards, you got to pay a lot to get one of these because there's just not very many of them. That's why this card is my 4th most valuable card. My 3rd most valuable card is the one and only Jinzo. This is the one we pulled in the 10K special. This is the one I pulled out of a first edition Pharaoh Servant box on my 500 subscriber special. Yeah. All the way back at 500 subscribers, and then it graded a 10, which was an incredible pull. At the time, I think it was worth $1,000 or $1,200 and a 10, which was a lot, obviously. I think it was my most expensive card at the time, which is pretty cool. And now it's gone up. I think, based on what I could gather, it's around $3,000. CyberDark Dragon may be worth more than this one, but I just like this guy. This guy has potential, you know, being the secret rare from Pharaoh Servant, iconic Jinzo. I'd say that I would bump him ahead. They're pretty close, though. A lot of these numbers, like 3rd and 4th, can be interchanged, but Jinzo, 1st edition PSA 10, probably worth around $3,000. Not totally sure. You guys can give me your sales numbers or what you've heard recently, and we can, you know, figure it out together in the comments, but that's what I've got for Jinzo, 1st edition Pharaoh Servant. We're down to the top two, and my 2nd most valuable card, Ancient Fairy Dragon Ghost Rare. This one is tough. These first edition PSA 10s are tough. This guy is extremely expensive. And the reason why this and the Black Rose are so expensive is they are from packs that do not have first edition North American booster boxes. The first edition packs only come out of 10s, or they come out of like pre-release, I think, which barely exist anymore. So it's basically you have to buy a 10. You get 2 first edition packs, and then you have a 1 out of 288 chance per pack. So like super low chance to pull the Ghost Rare. If you do, you go crazy. Then you have to hope it actually gets a 10. It's a Ghost Rare, so it's unlikely. So the value of these is just crazy in PSA 10. I think the pop's like 13 on this guy, or 12. So not many of these at all. Very expensive Ghost Rare, Ancient Fairy. I'd value it around $4,000. And honestly, that's not too bad for how expensive the Stardust and the Black Rose are in 10. This is actually pretty cheap comparatively. This one and the Majestic Star, I think, the one from Stardust Overdrive, those two are a little bit underrated right now, I think. But this guy, I'd value around $4,000 for my 2nd most valuable Yu-Gi-Oh card. Finally, my most expensive Yu-Gi-Oh card is Morphing Jar PSA 10 from Tournament Pack 2. This guy, far and away is my most valuable card for many reasons. One, it is an ultra rare from tournament pack two, the second tournament pack, probably the rarest tournament pack in general. It's very difficult to find those packs. I actually opened 20 of them on the channel. Go check that out. We didn't pull that. We didn't pull this out of that, but I did get this guy in a trade. I graded it a 10. It's 1 out of 108 tournament packs. Tournament packs are about, tournament pack 2 is at least $100 per pack. There's only 3 cards per pack. You have a 1 in 108 chance. So if you pay $100 times 108 just to get this guy, if you can even find 108, you know, that's $10,800 or whatever. A very expensive way to pull this guy. And you might not even get it because you'd have to buy sealed boxes and those are going to be even more than $100 per pack. So it's really tough. Then you have to actually grade it a 10. I think there's 22 of these in the population, but not like they're almost never for sale. I was offered around $8,000 for this card, so I would value it around there, maybe a little less if it's going to be, you know, an actual sale. Because, you know, offers mean something, but if they don't actually sell, then you can't totally value it at that. But I would say it's worth around that. I think there was a trade recently at about $8,000 value for a Morphing Jar. So that's pretty fair to go with. But obviously, even if it's worth $2,000 less, like $6,000, it's still my most valuable card. One of my favorite cards, it was an epic pickup that I graded. And an iconic card that was played back in the day. So a really cool card. My number one most valuable Yu-Gi-Oh card. So there it is. You guys saw my top 10 most valuable Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Let me know if you guys enjoyed it in the comments. I'll pop up a total value of what those 10 cards are worth. Yeah, so it's a lot. It's Yu-Gi-Oh cards, but they are now worth money. They're not worth nothing anymore. It's kind of crazy how expensive they are. But let me know in the comments some expensive cards that you own or some cards that you just really like that you have graded or maybe that you haven't graded. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. We will be opening up another 2003 10 this weekend. It's going to be pretty awesome. And we're fast approaching 25,000 subscribers. When we hit that, we're opening all 6 Yu-Gi-Oh 10s from 2003. It's going to be crazy. I also have an epic mail day coming up, possibly tomorrow or on Sunday. I don't know which one yet. I'm going to be showing you guys an epic product we're going to be opening. It was the one I teased on my story. It's crazy. So that's it for today, guys. I'll see you guys later. Peace.
It's the original art.
Yes! Yes!
Galaxy X.
First pack! Yeah!